Happy Easter! He has risen!
Feliz Domingo de Resurrección! Él ha resucitado!
Happy Easter!
He has risen!
Happy Easter! He has risen! He has risen indeed!
Happy Easter! He has risen! Hosam Pravlayam Sisef Sprasnikam Haski! Christos Vaskriya!
Happy Easter, everyone! He is risen!
From our family to yours! Happy Easter! He is risen!
Happy Easter! He is risen!
Happy Easter! He is risen!
Happy Easter! He has risen!
Happy Easter! He is risen!
Happy Easter! He is risen!
Happy Easter! He is risen!
Good morning, church. Welcome. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Thank you for joining us to this virtual service to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. We are glad that you're here with us. We hope that you enjoyed the service.
Did you feel the mountains tremble? Did you hear the oceans roar? When the people rose to sing of Jesus Christ the risen one. Did you feel the people tremble? Did you hear the singers roar? When the lost began to sing of Jesus Christ the saving one. And we can see that God, you're moving, a mighty river through the nations. When young and old will turn to Jesus, yeah, fling wide you heavenly gates. Saints join in one song, and all the streams flow as one river to wash away our brokenness. And here we see that God, you're moving, a time of jubilee is coming, when young and old return to Jesus, yeah. Fling wide you heavenly gates, prepare the way of the risen Lord. So open up the doors and let the music play. Let the streets resound with injustice. And here we see that God, you're moving a mighty river through the nations, and young and old will turn to Jesus. Fling wide you heavenly gates, prepare the way of the risen Lord. Yeah. Open up the doors and let the music play. Let the streets resound with singing. Did you feel the mountains tremble? Did you hear the oceans roar? When the people rose to sing of Jesus Christ, the risen one.
What a beautiful day this is to celebrate Easter Sunday. Easter morning, where we celebrate that the tomb is empty. I'm here outside of the church. I'm hearing all the birds. Special thanks to one of our parishioners, Skip, for watering, taking the time to water our plants and our grass and having this beautiful setting for you all. So with that in mind, let us pray this morning. Let us celebrate. Even in the midst of this pandemic, we can celebrate that Jesus is with us, and he is not in the tomb. He is risen indeed. Let us pray. Father God, Lord, we thank you this morning for the ability, Lord, to even in the midst of this current situation, to praise your name, to shout out victory, Lord, because you are not, you didn't stay in that empty tomb. Lord, we thank you because in you we know we are more than conquerors. Lord, I pray that this morning you fill the people who is with us, even through this virtual space, praising your name, that you give them the strength that they need to hold on in this difficult time. Lord, we pray for those who are fighting in the first lines, in the hospitals, making decisions, important decisions for our nation and for the world, that you also fill them with your spirit, Lord. And we thank you for the church in general, that as we gather this morning and we can pray all together, knowing and trusting that you hear our prayers, Lord. So we acknowledge all that always as we pray the way that you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
It's an act of worship to give God's tithes and offerings. And we want to thank you so much for your faithfulness and your fruitfulness. We are so glad that you continue to join us for worship online. You continue to support the ministries. We are moving forward strong. We're so glad that you continue to send us notes. This is from Pat and RJ. Thank you for all that you're doing to keep the church moving in this time of trouble. This too shall pass. That is true indeed. And from Audrey and Carlton, more encouragement, thanking the entire church staff for what they are doing. I want to give you thanks for all the different ways that we're supporting and helping this community in need and our families. The Go Team leadership is developing a food distribution program. As you are able to give, we encourage you to give just about $5 more. And for $5, we can fund and offer 2 hot meals. So we're going to launch this program starting this week, and we hope that you can join and participate. As you're able to give of your time, continue reading Psalm 91. Thank you so much for being the church in such difficult times. It is an Easter new day for all of us. God bless you.
When we cry for freedom, you tore down the walls. The weight of our burden.
Easter story, the resurrection of Jesus according to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 16, verses 1 through 7. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee, and there you will see him just as he told you." This is a different Easter. It's a new kind of Easter for us. Over the years, I believe our culture has attempted to improve how we celebrate Easter. Think about all the outfits coordinated, the family portraits, the Easter egg hunt, and the Easter bunnies, the selfies. One of the ones we enjoy seeing the church packed, definitely a great brunch. I've even seen how now it's an expectation to buy new toys and hand them to children. And that has been our attempt to make Easter better. So this Easter actually resonates a little bit more with the first Easter. That first Easter morning was a very quiet one. Those who had witnessed and heard of the death of Jesus were now hiding out, and they were mourning, and they were sad, and it was a very dark season. And they had to distance themselves from the world, because if they were caught out and recognized like one who followed that king of the Jews, they could face ramifications. Think also of the disciples, Mary, the mother of Jesus, and those who witnessed just 48 hours prior to this Easter morning, the pain, maybe flashbacks in their minds, hearing the groaning, the yelling, the violence. It was a traumatic experience to witness. It was a very dark time. It was part of the custom for people to go and take care of a dead body. So we read in the scripture how women were on their way to do just that. They were heading to take care of a dead body. And on the way there, they were talking about and asking, how are we going to get that stone moved? Who is going to roll it away for us? And when they got there, the stone was already moved. They went in, they saw a messenger, an angel basically, who said to them, as they were then alarmed, don't be alarmed. And then he invited them to take a closer look and see that is an empty tomb and that there's nobody there and Jesus is risen. Take a look for yourselves, he said to them. The messenger, with that invitation, makes a point, and I hope that we can apply it today, that we are to step in and take a closer look. What Easter is really about is the resurrection of Jesus, is life over death. It's victory over death. And for today's theme and purposes, I'm going to add the power of knowing that there was this stone moved away. Jesus is risen. And I believe that this Easter, it will be good for us to apply this invitation. And even though it is hard to believe in something that is beyond our understanding, as it was clearly hard for these women and for the disciples to believe that Jesus actually resurrected, when I think about the story, it was actually even hard for them to believe that he was going to be crucified. He warned them over and over again, and they only believed that he was going to be killed and hurt in the extent that he was once they saw that happened. So imagine how unbearable it was, how awful it was, that they just couldn't fathom the idea that it is true that he will be resurrected. They had to see it for themselves. I believe Jesus is risen. But I have to tell you that when I went to the Holy Land recently, I remember when we went to what is considered the area of the empty tomb, and we had to wait in line, and I was nervous. Maybe it's adrenaline. I know it's excitement, but there was something about touching. I wanted to touch. I wanted to actually go in, and I wanted to see for myself that this is the place where Jesus resurrected. There's something about seeing it for ourselves. The resurrection of Jesus Christ is the greatest story ever told. Unlike any other faith figure, Jesus is the only one who fulfills the promise of coming back to life, a resurrection. It changed radically the lives of the women who had the first encounter. I think it's so wonderful how God chose, considering how in those days, the role, the understanding of women, for me, it's amazing that he chose women to have the first encounter and then to become the first messengers of the greatest story. It's amazing. And then imagine the change in the disciples. We know of the story. Until that day, they were strong one day, and then their faith dwindled. They were found asleep many times. They denied Jesus. They betrayed Jesus. They were slow to have faith and believe and hang on to the faith. But after the resurrection, their lives changed drastically. And the disciples spread the good news all over the world. Something happened that day that changed the course of humanity. When you accept the resurrection of Jesus Christ, your life changes. So may you accept the invitation. May you take a closer look. C.S. Lewis, an author, maybe you may know him as the author of the Chronicles of Narnia. He's an incredible theologian, an author who, prior to becoming this well-renowned theologian, was an atheist. And he said, "What are we to make of Jesus Christ? He is either a liar, a lunatic, or Lord. If Jesus did not resurrect, he would have been a liar, or he was simply just crazy. But it happened. The tomb is empty. Jesus is Lord." We tend to rely on our own understanding to prove something to be true. Just like how we think we have made Easter better over the years, with all the fluff and the stuff, there's a lot in life that we believe we have made better, that we can rely in all of our efforts and strengths to guarantee a better future and a better quality of life. For example, we work hard and we only work harder and we keep working hard. And working hard is good. But to make it the way for us to have the most reliable future is not right. And look at us today, based on what the entire world is facing, we have been caught off guard. And it feels like this immovable kind of stone, extremely heavy, sealed, not going anywhere. So the question remains today, who is going to move the stone? Who is going to roll it away? Because it's not in my own efforts. It is good what we're doing. The fact that Easter is being celebrated virtually is because we are to collaborate and be part of the solution. But ultimately, we can't heal the world. We can't guarantee our future. Jesus Christ alone can move and roll away the stones. Easter is all about believing and leaning into a new way of life and a different perspective. A truer and reliable truth should rise in you and in me. It's about seeing that through Jesus Christ, there is always, always a breakthrough. Jesus died on the cross for all sins, sickness, and suffering. And the tomb is empty. He rose from the grave. When we have a relationship with the resurrected Lord, it changes the relationship to sin. This is very important for us to apply today. We can rise above sin. We can overcome sin. We don't need to believe that we are always at the weaker end, always to succumb to sin. No, through Jesus Christ, we can actually believe that a stumbling block or a huge stone in the way can actually be transformed into a milestone that we actually step over and we move forward. Either Jesus moves the stone or Jesus will move us. But in the end, Jesus is our breakthrough. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 14, and then I'll jump to verse 51. It reads, if Christ has not been raised, then our proclamation has been in vain, and your faith has been in vain. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your sting? 2 Corinthians chapter 5, there's a verse where it says, for the love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for all, and he died for all so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and raised for them. We are living in uncertain times, but there is one thing that is certain and guaranteed, that Christ is risen. Christ is with us. In Christ, there's a way, there's truth, and there's life. Take a closer look. Invite the Holy Spirit to rise in you once again, the faith, to experience firsthand the power of Jesus Christ, who will remove and move all stones from our path. In the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. We are sent forth in the power of Christ's resurrection. May you go now with the peace of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord, with the love of God, and in communion with the Holy Spirit to be with us all. Amen.